Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm doing systems of equation word problems today. Distance problems first. Read the problem. A boat goes 240 miles upstream in 15 hours. The return trip takes 8 hours. Find the speed of the boat in still water and the speed of the current. So when we're going upstream and then returning back, we assume that the distances are going to be the same. Whenever we're working with distance, rate, and time problems, we're talking about D equals RT. That's a basic concept for travel problems. I'm going to let B be the speed of the boat in still water and C be the speed of the current. We're going to assume the current stays the same during the entire trip. When the boat is going downstream, it's faster because of the current. So if we want to talk about the rate of the boat as it travels downstream, it's the boat and the current added together. So the speed of the boat plus that current is pushing it when it's going downstream. So we get B plus C. That's going to be the rate of the boat. Okay, when the boat is going upstream, it is slowed by the current. So the rate of the boat with the current is being against the current, I should say, is slowing it down. So it's B minus C. Notice that I always put the B first. The boat is first. It's the boat that's being slowed by the current. We don't want to say the current is being slowed by the boat, because it's not. The current's moving along at its pace. It doesn't care what's happening to the boat. But the boat, we take away or add the current depending on whether it's going up with the up against the stream or down with the stream. Okay, the distance traveled on both legs of the journey is 240 miles. Upstream is 15 hours and downstream is 8 hours. We know that because it was given, and we know that distance equals rate times time. So for downstream, we know the distance was 240 miles. We know that the rate was B plus C for downstream. That's the boat plus the current all together gave us a rate of B plus C. And the time was 8 hours. That was given downstream. Upstream, the time given was 15 hours. And we know upstream it was working against the current, so it was B minus C. Again, traveled 240 miles. What I'm going to do is divide both those 240 by 8 and 240 by 15 to give me an equation that looks a little nicer. And when I do that, 240 divided by 8 gives me 30, and 240 divided by 15 gives me 16. And that's the systems of equation that I want to solve then. Look how easy this one is. It's ready to be added together to eliminate. The C's go away, and I get 2B equals 46. And I know that if I divide both of those by 2, I get B equals 23. That means the boat was going 23 miles per hour. If that's true, and I know that B plus C equals 30, then I could say, well, my boat was going 23. My current then had to be going 7. So the speed of the boat and this is in still water, was 23 miles per hour. And the speed of the current was 7 miles per hour. Notice 23 minus 7 would be 16, but 23 plus 7 would be 30. So that's a distance, rate, and time problem with the distances being equal. All right, let's look at one more of those. A plane can fly 3,660 miles in 6 hours with the wind. Again, we're talking about going against the wind and with the wind, just like we were with the current. Flying against the wind, it can fly 2,940 miles in the same amount of time. Notice here that the times are the same, the distances are different. Find the wind speed and the speed of the plane. That would be the speed of the plane without having any wind pushing it around. So I'm going to let P be the speed of the plane and W be the speed of the wind. And the rate of the plane with the wind. Well, when it's going with the wind, it's got its own speed plus the wind is pushing it along faster. You've heard the captain say, oh, because of the tailwind, we're going to get there a little early. That's because the wind is pushing that along and helping. Whereas when you're going against the wind, You've got the plane speed, but now the wind is slowing it down. Again, if you put wind minus P, that's different. That's saying the plane would be slowing the wind down, which it isn't. The wind is slowing the plane down, so it's taking away from the plane's speed. All right, remember that distance equals rate times time. With the wind, well, with the wind, we're going plane plus wind. It took 6 hours to fly 3,660 miles. And if I divide 3,660 by 6, I get P plus W equals 610. For the other one, I'm going against the wind. Again, I flew for 6 hours, but I went against the wind, and I had a total distance of 2,940. And if I divide 2,940 by 6, I get 490. So here's my systems of equation. Again, I cleaned it up by dividing both sides by 6. Now, this again is nice and easy, ready to go, because the W's are going to cancel, and I have 2P is 1,100. So if I'm going to take 610 plus 490 and divide by 2, I should get 550. Sometimes I just check my math because it's a pain later on to have somebody comment on my video and say, you added 5 and 6 wrong or whatever. So I got this right, it looks like. The plane is flying. This is the plane speed. If the plane could just fly in still air with no wind, it could go at 550 miles per hour. But it's not doing that. We have the plane plus the wind is 610. We now know the plane was 550. And so we can figure out that by subtracting 550, I get 60. So the wind speed is 60 miles per hour. So we have the plane speed is 550. If I add 60 to that, I'm going to be going 610. If I subtract 60 from that, I'm going to go 490. So that's a typical distance, rate, and time problem using systems of equations. Have a fantastic day.